What up? This is JP from Off the Ball Network giving you a recap of week 12 of college football. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Hopefully everyone will have a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. Let's go ahead and get into the college football recap. Before we get into the recap, make sure you subscribe down below to Off the Ball Network for all your sports needs. All the previous videos that we've been putting up and everything, check it out. Also, follow us on our social media platforms. Also, check out offtheballnetwork.com for all your sports needs, articles, podcasts. Everything you need is on offtheballnetwork.com. We are getting heavy into college basketball season 2. College football is still going. NFL still going. NBA season is just heating up so far. So definitely check out offtheballnetwork.com. And shout out to the guys from Off the Ball Network doing their thing. So let's go ahead and get into the recap. So we had San Diego State versus UNLV in the Mountain West Division. San Diego State picking up the victory 28-20. They played well in the first half, scoring 21 points. Then didn't really play well in the second half, only scoring just 7 points and all that. Let UNLV kind of come back in the third quarter, just scoring 10 points and everything. But, you know, they sealed it. They sealed it late with a touchdown late in the fourth quarter just to seal the game. So San Diego State 28-20. Then we have Memphis versus Houston. Wasn't really a close contest. Houston picked up the victory 31-13, scoring 21 points in the second quarter. And the fourth quarter scoring 10 points and everything. Toon played really well, 28 out of 34, 264 yards and a touchdown. Henry, 13 carries, 73 yards and a touchdown. So definitely shout out to Houston. Then we had Charleston Southern versus Georgia. I mean, Georgia's the best team in college football out right now. 56-7, wasn't really a close score. Bennett, 105 yards, 2 touchdowns, going 8 out of 14. Didn't really play much and all that because they were just destroying them and everything. White with 83 yards and a touchdown. Seethu, 39 yards, 1 touchdown, 2 carries. Then we had Arkansas versus Alabama. Really close game, which is kind of surprising in Alabama standards. But 42-35 with the victory. Bryce Young passed for more yards than any quarterback ever had in the game. 559 yards for Bryce Young, 31 out of 45 touchdowns. Man, this guy is going to be in the Heisman vote. You know, he'll probably be like either like first or front runner at least, just depending. Robinson Jr., 122 yards. Williams, 3 touchdowns, 190 yards on 8 receptions. But yeah, you know, kind of letting Arkansas kind of come back in the fourth quarter, you know, scoring 14 points. But yeah, Alabama did their damage in the second quarter with 21 points and then scoring 18 points in the second half too as well. Then we have Oregon versus Utah, where we have an upset. Utah destroyed Oregon, which is surprising, 38-7. Wow. And this is the battle in the Pac-12 where we think Oregon's going to win the Pac-12 championship. But man, Utah put the brakes on them, man. Thomas, 21 carries, 94 yards, 3 touchdowns. Like, he just could not be stopped. They just could not be stopped. And a 78-yard punt return touchdown as the first half ends for Utah. They scored 21 points in the second quarter. Whew. Man, Oregon was just really struggling. Like, they were really struggling on Saturday against Utah. And Utah's no joke either. They're 8-3, they're 7-1 in the Pac-12. So, I mean, they're pretty dangerous. They're pretty dangerous in that Pac-12. Then we have Michigan State versus Ohio State. What an impressive victory by Ohio State, letting Michigan State score nothing until the fourth quarter. But it was pretty much a blowout, though. Like, if you just look at it, they scored 49 points in the first half. It was 49-0. It was just, like, shocking because Michigan State couldn't do anything. I mean, they couldn't do anything against Ohio State. So it was a really impressive game. C.J. Stroud, another person that could be up for Heisman, 32 out of 35, 432 yards, 6 touchdowns. 6 touchdowns. Just unbelievable. Teague III, 95 yards on 21 carries and a touchdown. Olave with 140 yards on 7 receptions, 2 touchdowns. I mean, but C.J. Stroud is the player of the game by far. 6 touchdowns, 432 yards. Just light up Michigan State's defense. Woo. Man. Woof. Then we have SMU versus Cincinnati. Cincinnati is still undefeated, 11-0, 7-0 in the American Conference. Desmond Ridder, 17 out of 23, 274 yards and 3 touchdowns. Ford, 82 yards, 1 touchdown on 20 carries. 114 yards and 7 receptions for Tucker out of for Cincinnati. 48-14 was the final score. They pretty much scored double figures the first three quarters, and then SMU couldn't do anything until the fourth quarter. They only scored 14 points. So, and that was all in the fourth quarter when they probably pretty much took everyone out, the starters out for Cincinnati. So, then we have Michigan versus Maryland, where everybody kept talking about Jim Harbaugh might leave for like the NFL, but I doubt he would because he loves just the Michigan atmosphere and everything. So I doubt he'll leave Michigan. Maybe one day, maybe just one day. But 59-18 was the final score. Michigan scoring 24 points in the first half, and then they scored 28 points alone in the third quarter. Man, Case Benoit, 259 yards, 2 touchdowns, scored 21 out of 28. Haskins, 78 yards, 2 touchdowns on 20 carries. Edwards, 10 receptions, 170 yards, and 1 touchdown. So, yeah, it was pretty much not really a close game. I'll just say that for sure. Bad defense by Maryland. Just bad defense. Then we had Notre Dame versus Georgia Tech, 55-0. Notre Dame, 10-1, 6-1 at home. Very impressive. They shut out Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech didn't score nothing. I mean, just nothing. Cone with 285 yards and 2 touchdowns, going 15 out of 20. We have Oklahoma State versus Texas Tech, 23-0. Oklahoma State, Sanders, 239 yards, 1 touchdown, going 19 out of 37. But yeah, he was the player of the game. State destroyed Texas Tech. I'll just say that. Now, here comes the shocking upset of the weekend. Wake Forest going up against Clemson. Clemson, you know, was in the top, you know, 10, and then they just kind of just didn't have a great season. Like, the quarterback is just iffy. You know, they don't really have really much of an offense game. I feel bad for Justin Ross because, you know, he don't really have anyone. That offense is just pleated. The defense is still really good, though, but, like, that offense is just pleated. It's just, ugh. But 48-27, Clemson. Their winning game, Pace, 191 yards, 2 touchdowns, 24 carries. Shipley with 2 touchdowns himself. I mean, that winning game, like, Wake Forest couldn't even stop it. They just could not stop it. Hartman, you know, 27 out of 43, 312 yards to the touchdown. Collins, 137 yards, a touchdown on 4 receptions. I mean, Clemson put the brakes off of them. I mean, they just beat the brakes off of them. So they're 6-2 in the ACC. Wake Forest got his 6-1 with that loss to Clemson, but they're still 9-2 though. But they dropped down so many spots though when the rankings came out today. So, but yeah, congratulations to Clemson. Go Tigers! Then we got Baylor versus Kansas State, 22-0. Baylor. Then we have Ole Miss versus Vanderbilt, 31-17. Ole Miss scored 24 points in the first half. Then Matt Corral, 27 out of 36, 226 yards and 2 touchdowns. I mean, they were just, I mean, Vanderbilt, it was just too much Ole Miss. It was just too much Ole Miss that game. Then we have Oklahoma, who they just lost last week going against Iowa State. 28-21 was a kind of a close game, especially the fourth quarter, letting Iowa State come back. Because it was 14-7 at halftime. And then Oklahoma just really just scored just like 7 points each quarter. Like, they just kept consistent right there, you know? But yeah. But yeah, but there was a big hit too as well that led to a big man touchdown for Oklahoma. I mean, oof, that hit was just, that was just vicious. Like, ooh, can I see that again? Like, it was just like one of those, like, let me see that again. And that came with a touchdown. Then we have BYU versus Georgia Southern, 34-17. BYU, Hall with 312 yards, 2 touchdowns, scored 17 out of 29. Aguilar, 136 yards, 1 touchdown on 25 carries. Then we have Nebraska versus Wisconsin, who've been really impressive in that Big Ten. They're 6-2 and 8-3 overall, 35-28, Wisconsin. Allen, 228 yards, 3 touchdowns on 22 carries. Texas A&M versus Perryville A&M. The battle of the A&Ms, 52-3, Texas A&M. It wasn't really close. Kazala with 150 yards, scored 10 out of 14, two touchdowns. Muhammad the third, two touchdowns with 77 yards on five receptions. Iowa versus Illinois, 33-23, Iowa. Goodson, 132 yards. Then we have Virginia versus Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh, 48-38. Shout out to Davis with 100 yards. Addison, 202 yards, four touchdowns. Four touchdowns. Whew-wee. They scored 24 points in the second quarter, 14 points in the fourth quarter, and 10 points in the third quarter. So Pittsburgh is just sealing it out. It's just sealing it out. Then we have Syracuse versus NC State, 41-17, NC State. Leary, 303 yards, two touchdowns, going 17 out of 24. Thomas with 80 yards and a touchdown. Then we have UTSA versus UAB, 31-34. Close game with UTSA winning. Harris, 323 yards, 25 out of 36, and three touchdowns. Then we have Mississippi State versus Tennessee State. Wasn't really much of a close game, 55-10. Five touchdowns and 391 yards for Wadrill, scored 28 out of 34. Johnson, 56 yards and a touchdown. Polk, 110 yards and a touchdown on nine receptions. And that was your college football recap from over the weekend. Definitely happy Thanksgiving to everybody. Tell me your biggest loser, your biggest winner, your favorite game, anything from this past weekend's college football, and what game you're looking forward to this week on Thanksgiving week. It's rivalry week, so I'm very excited. I know what mine is. It's going to be Clemson versus South Carolina. And that's because, look, it's, you know, South Carolina. It's the battle of South Carolina. You know, we hate Clemson and USC. We hate each other. We hate each other. So that's going to be a fun game to watch, hopefully. So I'm definitely going to be tuning in for that one. Subscribe down below to Off the Ball Network for all your sports needs. Definitely follow us on our social media platforms. And also check out offtheballnetwork.com. Everything you need is on offtheballnetwork.com. Just check it out. I'm JP, and we're out of here.